Welcome to the Corel tutorial on using PaintShop Pro's Png Optimizer. Png, which stands for Portable Network Graphic, is a common file format that allows for various color palettes and transparencies for blending with other images or backgrounds when being placed onto web pages. In short, it's a common web image file format. The Png Optimizer in PaintShop Pro, as the name suggests, adjusts Png files for such factors as transparencies, colors, size, and download times to make loading web pages more efficient and color correct. PaintShop Pro also includes optimizers for GIFs and JPEGs. The PNG optimizer is a non-destructive feature in that it will not alter the original image, but saves a new version instead. Let's start by taking a quick look at what images might look like before being run through the optimizer. Here are two images that have been created for Corel's Discovery Center website. Notice that the background has been designated transparent as noted by the checkerboard border. This indicates the parts that will be replaced by whatever is behind it on the web page. Later in this tutorial, I will show you how to use the optimizer to actually create the transparency. In the meantime, this background can actually be customized to your liking. Go to Preferences, General Program Preferences, Transparency and Shading. In this panel, you can make several aesthetic adjustments. Change the grid size from tiny to large. Change the scheme to various color combinations. You can also determine if your final image uses transparency from a layer or from an alpha channel. To do this, go to Preferences, File Format Preferences, PNG tab. Most common transparencies come from layers, though. All right, let's optimize this file for the Corel website. Select the image you want and go to File, Export, PNG Optimizer. At the top, you have before and after views, so you can compare your changes with the original. You may also zoom into the images for a better view. A key item to note are the before and after file sizes. This is updated every time you make a relevant change. You'll see below that the current color palette being used is 24-bit. Watch the file size change when I choose palette-based, which is currently set to 256 colors. That is a huge difference. You'll also notice the change in the image quality itself when I zoom in here. Notice also that when I select palette-based, the dithering option becomes highlighted. Dithering is the feature that can be used to combine existing colors that are in your palette to mimic another color that is not in your palette. Notice the color pattern of the blue here at both zero dithering, then at 100% dithering, as existing colors are used to imitate and replace non-existing ones. It's up to you whether you want to use this feature. In the Transparency tab, no transparency will turn any checkerboard pattern to white. Single color transparency will turn on the choices below of what areas of the image you would like to be transparent. We'll keep it existing image or layer transparency since our image already has designated the border to be invisible. Remember that alpha channel transparency is also a choice. If your background is a color other than white, you can choose which color will be transparent. The gamma setting helps the image appear consistent across multiple display devices. If in doubt, you should keep it as the default PC value. PNG images can be interlaced or non-interlaced, which affects how the image is displayed on the computer with a slow internet connection. Although not nearly as important these days, but still may be important for certain audiences you're hoping to reach, the size of the compressed file and an estimate of the download times at four different modem speeds are displayed under the Download Times tab. Once you're done, click OK and save your file. Open up a browser, preferably Chrome, and drag and drop your newly optimized image right into a new tab. If you're using Chrome, the background defaults to black in this situation. To prove this, right-click on the browser page and select Inspect. Here is where the background color is determined and where it can be changed. Notice if I change it to any other color, that new color still fills any transparent areas of my image. All right, so what happens if you have an image that doesn't yet have a transparent background? Luckily, the PNG Optimizer will greatly simplify this process with only minimal setup. Let me show you. Here I have a stock image with a white background. Two things to note. The optimizer lets you choose only one color to be transparent, so make sure that color is nowhere else in the image unless you want it to also be transparent. Second, the background layer cannot contain transparency. Step one is done. I only want the white to be transparent. For the second step, right-click on the background layer and select Promote Background Layer. The red heart now floats above the background. Return to the PNG Optimizer and select the Transparency tab. Select Single Color Transparency. Select areas that match this color. Click the color chip, and instead of picking the color off the color wheel, simply click on the heart's white background. Click OK, and you'll see in the after window that white is now transparent. Click OK again. Save your image to the desktop and again drop it onto a blank Chrome window, and you'll see that the white background has now become the same color as Chrome's background. Alright, so what if you're still unsure of many of these settings you're trying to choose from? That's where the wizard could come into play. Let's see how that works. Turn now to the PNG Optimizer. Click Use Wizard to go through all six choices. On page 1, let's stick with palette based and click Next. Page 2, keep it as existing as you don't need to add any new colors to the transparency. Click Next. Page 3, keep it as white. Click Next. Page 4, choose web safe colors for anything less than 24-bit and click Next. On page 5, bring the slider to about a quarter to a third of the way and click Next. On page 6, you'll see the results. As an option, go back to page 2 and choose No Transparency, and then go back to page 6. You'll notice that the checkerboard pattern is now white. Return it back to the way it was. Click Finish, name your image, and save it. So that's a good overview of using the PNG Optimizer, what's possible, and the many different options you have available to you. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along and find other helpful tutorials for working with transparencies in PaintShop Pro.